Welcome back to Studio 10. Well, it has been said that sometimes in tragedy we find our life's true purpose. And that certainly is the case for our next guest. We'll meet Jimmy in a minute, but first, here's his story.
It's one of the world's biggest killers, and in Australia, one in 500 children will develop some form of cancer before the age of 15. With a 50% mortality rate, 200 children are diagnosed with a brain tumour every year. On New Year's Day 2010, while Australians celebrated new beginnings and made plans for the future, 7-year-old Emily was diagnosed with an aggressive brain tumour. Sadly, while she lost her battle, her death would change one man's life forever. Born and raised in Adelaide, Jimmy Harrington worked part-time in a cafe, and it was here that he first learnt of the little girl called Emily.
She was always smiling, which is what I found so courageous through what she was going through, because cancer is such a terrible experience, and she was always smiling. She was never bringing anyone down around her. She was always making everyone feel comfortable about her illness.
The two would cross paths at the cafe many more times over the next year, until Emily died 1 week before her 9th birthday. It was something Jimmy never thought could happen, and it was at this point he started walking in a different direction.
It's changed my life and helping me create awareness for childhood cancer in general. So because of her, she created, I think, the better side of me.
What an extraordinary little girl, Jimmy. Welcome to the show. We're also joined by Belinda from the charity Brainchild, which we'll hear more about in just a moment. But first up, Jimmy, what was it about Emily that touched you so deeply?
She was just her love of life. She was always smiling, and just seeing her so bubbly and through experience like that just made me want to get out there and do something for charity.
But you never spoke to each other, did you?
No. So just watching her and seeing her interact with others. She's so, like, she was 8 years old, and to go through what she had to go through was, you know.
How old are you?
I'm 21 now.
Because you look at those lovely pictures of Emily, that little sweetie pea in her fairy dress, and you understand how she would have had such an impact on you.
Yeah. She was incredible.
Tell us about Jimmy's walk for cancer and how it all came about.
Yeah, well, after Emily passed away, I wanted to do something for charity, and then so I started to work out what I can do, and I started working, planning a walk around Adelaide, and then it sort of snowballed into a walk around Australia. And
oh my goodness, yeah, that's a lot of walking.
How did it start, Jimmy? I mean, it's such a moving story. We've got such empathy to just look at a child and to feel for her even without even saying anything.
Yeah.
When she didn't come back, obviously you think, oh my God, she's actually dead. She's not here anymore, and I imagine that's when it really hit home.
Yeah.
Did you then say, all right, well, that's it, I'm just going to start walking? Like, what was the moment when you decided to...
Well, I didn't realise how, you know, aggressive childhood cancer was until actually she passed away. And I sort of, you know, kids, you think they get better straight away. But then when she actually didn't pass, when she passed away, I was like, you know, this is something I have to do for kids, for the future, and for this amazing charity.
You're such a lovely young man. Who says Jen Y doesn't do anything, you know?
Hello.
Belinda,
we
take it all back. I take it all back.
Belinda, let's bring you in now. You're from Brainchild. Can you tell us about some of the ways you'll be making a difference with that money
with
that Jimmy
raises? The amazing money that Jimmy has brought in. Well, sadly, Emily is not a single case. There is, you know, a lot of children diagnosed with brain and spinal cord tumours in Australia every year, and it's the leading cause of cancer death in children. Wow. So we're there. I've personally been through it. My son was diagnosed with a malignant brain tumour 8 years ago. He's now 21 and doing very well.
Oh my God, wow.
But we're very lucky. So Brainchild supports the families. We provide financial support by way of just little simple things, parking vouchers, shopping vouchers, petrol vouchers. We help them with bills that they can't pay. They have to leave their homes for many, many, many months. They have to leave their jobs. It's about the family. It's about the journey.
Because they have to be at the hospital while the child
Absolutely.
Gets the treatment.
Well, my son alone, I mean, I'm an isolated case, but we were in hospital for almost, you know, on and off for a year. Some of them are many years. And there's so many ongoing issues with brain tumours especially. just the issues that come from surgery, from treatment, you know, blindness, deafness.
So how much money did Jimmy raise?
He's so far raised about $160,000.
Wow! And Jimmy, that's an extraordinary amount of money, and if people want to donate as well, they can go to the website, which is jimmyswalkforcancer.com. So $160,000?
Yeah.
I reckon we could bump that up a bit. We've got a bit of a surprise. Hello?
You've done such a great job, but we reckon another 5K.
And also, that all comes out of my paycheck, so spend it well.
Let's make it 10.
Jimmy Blinder, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much.